Simon & Schuster Audio presents Word of Mouse, 101 Plus Trends on How We Buy, Sell, Live, Learn, Work, and Play by Marc Ostrofsky. Read by Kirby Heyborne.
Forward. Clate Mask, CEO and co-founder Infusionsoft. My world revolves around the success of small businesses. As the CEO of Infusionsoft, I am all about helping small businesses find more customers, get repeat sales, and save time, which means saving money. In today's incredibly competitive world, that's a lot harder than it once was. The Yellow Pages is dead. Print advertising is tougher than ever. As Mark said in his previous book, Get Rich Click, suspects, prospects, and clients are hanging out online. The ultimate competitive advantages are automation and technology tools that simultaneously increase sales and lower costs. The old world of business has changed dramatically. It's a digital world today. The process of efficiently finding, landing, and serving customers, what our organization calls the perfect customer lifecycle, brings with it a host of complexities. SEO, PPC, and blogs, multiple tools and systems, technologies that don't work well together, information overload. It can quickly become chaos for anyone in business, the entrepreneur who simply wants to run a successful business, or a parent who simply wants to communicate with his or her teenager. So what does all of this mean? It means that along with the digital revolution comes the cold hard fact that companies today must assign technology the critical role of gaining the upper hand to help all of us succeed in business. If we want more customers, repeat sales, and better efficiency, if we want success in our businesses, we've got to embrace technology, not just for our competitive advantage, but also for our very survival. The writing is on the wall. Those businesses that adapt will succeed. Those that don't will be left behind. And that's why this book is so important. Word of Mouse helps readers see the impact of internet technology and adapt to the future, in life and in business. Mark shows us the trends, the case studies, and the impact of the internet and its associated technologies in a way that readers can't ignore. He helps readers see how the gradual rise of the internet has changed everything, even though we may not recognize how it is impacting us. This book will open your eyes to a world of opportunity you probably didn't know existed. In the chapters that follow, you'll hear about the emerging trends and the ways that everyday people, just like you, are using technology to achieve breakthrough success. Through Mark's years of experience and his in-depth research, he brings a wealth of expertise that you can apply in your business to achieve greater levels of success or in everyday life, to simply stay in touch with your friends on Facebook, via Twitter, or through Pinterest. The case studies are my favorite part of the book, and that's not just because some of them feature Infusionsoft customers. See more about their success at www.infusionsoft.com/case studies. While it's true that I love to see our customers effectively using our software to find more customers, get repeat sales, and save time, there's another reason why I love the case studies. In working with entrepreneurs for many, many years, I've noticed that most of them struggle to see the better way to use technology until they see that same technology being used by someone like them in a similar business. Mark has done a great job of making these case studies vivid, real, and easy to understand so that you can see how you or your firm can employ the same techniques and technologies. In short, Mark teaches the way they do at Harvard Business School, using real-life examples to show you how to achieve greater success in your business through the effective use of technology. The digital revolution has thrust technology to the forefront of the small business success equation. It truly levels the playing field and gives any small or mid-sized business a huge leg up on the competition. It can be daunting to navigate the waters in this new world, but you can do it. My hope is that you will use this book as a resource in your sales and marketing efforts as you embrace the internet and adopt technology. I am confident that as you study the trends and the examples, your eyes will be opened to new ways that you can achieve small business success. Although I gravitate toward the business applications of the content, this book is written for consumers. Marc focuses his serial entrepreneur trend-watching lens on the internet-driven changes he observes today and how they will evolve. The book is a wake-up call for consumers who are immersed in technology but are sleepwalking through its impact. Whether voluntarily, involuntarily, consciously, subconsciously, or unconsciously, we have assigned technology a dominant role in our lives. Taking the time to understand the mind-body-internet connection is key to ensuring that consumers let that dominance work in their favor in a way that it is welcome, efficient, productive, and transparent. This book brings listeners to that understanding. It gives listeners the tools they need to dig themselves out from under the information overload that otherwise paralyzes their use of today's digital delivery systems. It is a brilliantly conceived assimilation of trends, case studies, forecasts, apps, and tips for getting plugged in that will put listeners in the driver's seat of the world's most powerful, most disruptive force to date. A special bonus chapter guides consumers through the perils of cybercrime with practical steps on how to avoid becoming a victim. Listeners of his book will finish it in an awakened state, feeling smarter, more engaged, and more the masters of the digital world that surrounds them. Preface. I am a golfer. I just love to go out and play golf. Maybe it's because no one is the best at it, or because of the truism of golf, the harder you swing the club, the worse you will do. Golfers will understand that irony, but it's a hard, wonderful, maddening, and perplexing sport. I do love it. For 20 years, I have purchased my golf clubs, golf shoes, and thousands of golf balls, most of which now reside at the bottom of a lake, at a small local retail golf shop owned by a nice guy named Jim Harrison. I went in one day about 6 months ago to find a sign on the door saying, "Store closing, new location, TBA." I was shocked. Jim had been there for almost 25 years. At the register was another note written on a yellow notepad. "We lost our lease. We have 30 days to vacate. Please give us your email address so we can tell you our new address when we have one. Thanks, Jim." What a shame, I thought. The guy has no clue. In today's tech speak, what ran through my head was, "OMG, are you kidding me? He doesn't have a database of his clients and their email addresses?" Sure enough, Jim said he didn't and never thought he needed one. Jim said something I'd heard 100 times before. Why should I? All of my customers know me, and I know them. Now that Jim was moving to a new location, he didn't have a quick way of telling everyone where and when he'd be open for business again. Only if someone walked into the store during that 30-day period and was served by Jim or another employee would he or she know the details of the move. To make matters worse, what was the likelihood that even informed customers would remember that Jim had moved and where he was moving to the next time they needed golf supplies? And none of these problems takes into account the fact that, as of my visit, Jim still hadn't found a new location. It was entirely possible that he wouldn't have a new site before he was forced to leave the building and all his customers behind. Jim was in trouble for sure. Can you imagine? 25 years of hard work, striving every day to build a business, only to have it vanish in 30 days? It's like having all of your assets in a home with no fire insurance when a fire breaks out and burns everything down to a pile of ashes. Jim was truly upset over the situation. The truth was, though, he was mad mostly at himself. And he was scared, because this turn of events meant that he had to start over from the ground up, as though he'd never had a customer in his life. The point of the story? Here are six good ones. 1. Jim is typical of many people today, assuming a mindset of, I've always done it this way, so why should I change? Until something like Jim's situation happens, these people continue doing everything the same old way. 2. Jim never knew that he could get more business by communicating with his clients via word of mouth, via email, Facebook, LinkedIn, and many other tools of the internet age. 3. Jim doesn't know what he doesn't know. These days, you must observe what other businesses are doing to stay connected with customers, such as having a database of your clients and segmenting which ones spend the most money with you. You also must determine whether you understand the problems you have in a contemporary context. For example, are you losing out to the competition because they have a better social media strategy than you, if you even have one, that is? Are you complacent about checking online reviews regarding your business, and have you perhaps missed a single negative review by a disgruntled customer with the unfortunate impact of lowering your average star rating? Finally, you need to find someone to help you fix, or avoid, problems using state-of-the-art technology. 4. Jim thought he was merely in a brick-and-mortar business located in a small strip mall, not in the information and/or communications business. He thought word of mouth would suffice, when what he really needed was word of mouth. 5. Jim never hired his weakness, a key strategy in my world of teaching others how to be successful, especially in business. The strategy goes hand in hand with know what you don't know to help navigate in our new information age. Jim didn't know technology, email, databases, internet marketing, and so on, so he should have hired somebody who did. 6. You can tell from Jim's note that he wanted email addresses only to inform his clients where he was moving. He still had no clue how to use an email address as a free way to communicate quickly to his prospects and clients. To alert them to the move was the first application. To tell them of great weekly sales and to invite them in for the Titleist Golf Club demo day were just two of hundreds of other uses for those email addresses. I have learned a valuable lesson from being in business for the last 30 years.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.